students, I hope you must be fine. Today we will discuss explain why question of the central nervous system. First question is, explain why stronger stretch may lead to relaxation of muscle. As I told you in the previous video, when the muscle is stretched, there is contraction of the muscle due to stretch reflex, and the two neurons involved are one a fiber taking sensory input from the muscle and alpha fiber giving final common neuronal pathway for muscle contraction. These are sensory fiber and this is the motor fiber. But when you are stretching the muscle within a limit, it will contract. But when you go beyond the limit, opposite happens. It gets relaxed because of the inverse stretch reflex. Inverse stretch reflex is just opposite to the stretch reflex, okay? And in this, the sensory organ is Golgi tendon organ, which are in the series of the muscle, not parallel. For this, for stretch reflex, the intrafusal fiber or muscle spindles were in parallel to the extrafusal fiber. But in inverse stretch reflex, the sensory receptors, which are Golgi tendon organs, they are in series of the muscle, and when they get stimulated, they give afferent to the 1B. For stretch reflex, 1A is there. For inverse stretch reflex, 1B is there. In stretch reflex, two words are there. So, 1A, two word, okay. And in inverse stretch reflex, three words are there. So, next level, 1B. These are sensory fiber. To remember it, I am just giving you trick. Stretch reflex A, inverse stretch reflex B. These sensory receptors are going and they are ending on one interneuron, and this interneuron is inhibitory. So it is giving negative feedback to the alpha neuron, leading to relaxation of the muscle. This neuron stimulate alpha neuron and this pathway inhibit alpha neuron. And when alpha neuron is inhibited, there is relaxation of the muscle. And this reflex is also responsible for the clasp knife rigidity. In clasp knife, when we try to close the arm, initially a much resistance is felt because of stretch reflex. And finally, the limb closes with a sudden jerk because of inverse stretch reflex. Next question is, explain why paraplegic patients often scratch the inside of thigh to initiate micturition. First of all, tell me, what is paraplegia? Paraplegia is paralysis of both the lower limb. Whereas hemiplegia is paralysis of the half of the body. One upper limb and one lower limb of the same side. Okay. So, in paraplegia, there is initiation of micturition. First of all, tell me, paraplegia occurs in which condition? Paraplegia occurs in spinal cord injury. If the injury to the spinal cord at the lower level, there can be paraplegia. One question was there in what will happen and why, that what will happen if there is spinal cord injury at the level of cervical spine. In that, the patient will die. But at the lower level, it will lead to the paraplegia. So, in paraplegia, there are various phases, and when the reflex activity comes back, there is one reflex known as mass reflex. In mass reflex, when the person scratches the inner part of the thigh, inner aspect of the thigh, it lead to micturition, it lead to emptying of the bowel, it lead to pallor, sweating, and even swinging of the blood pressure. Basically, what happens when there is spinal cord is transected? The inhibitory neurons coming from the brain to the lower part are withdrawn. The upper motor neuron response is withdrawn. Now, the lower motor neurons see various phenomena. In that, one phenomena is irradiation. It means the stimulus which should be capped in a lower manner, means the stimulus should be only on that part which is concerned with the reflex activity. But in this phenomena, stimulus is here, but it spreads to so many parts of the body. That is irradiation. radiation. Radiation means spreading of the stimulus or impulse to many neurons, leading to these phenomena. Okay, and in these paraplegic patients which are having spinal cord transection, there is already loss of bowel and bladder habit because all are controlled from the brain. And when these person gains some kind of reflex activity or some kind of control on bowel and bladder by emptying the bowel and bladder, by pinching the inner aspect of the thigh, and this all happens due to mass reflex in which there is pallor and sweating and fluctuation of blood pressure, and this happens due to irradiation in the neurons. Next question is, explain why dissociative anesthesia is found in syringomyelia. What is syringomyelia? In syringomyelia, what happens in spinal cord, the cavity, this is central canal, and due to gliosis and cavity formation, the anterior fibers and lateral fibers of this get gradually destroyed. Okay, and in spinal cord, I have already told you there are three pathways. One is anterior spinothalamic tract, which is taking crude touch. One is lateral spinothalamic tract, which is taking to higher side pain and temperature. And one is dorsal column, which is carrying all the sensation related to fine touch, that is tactile localization, tactile discrimination, rough aesthesia, stereognosis, all the finer aspect of the touch. And when these anterior and lateral fibers are lost, which lead to injury to the anterior spinothalamic tract and lateral spinothalamic tract. So tell me what modalities would be lost. One is crude touch and one is pain and temperature. But there is no loss of fibers of the dorsal column. So fine touch would be there and all the finer aspect of the touch would be there. So there would be dissociative sensory loss. Some sensory modalities are lost and some sensory modalities are preserved. Okay. Crude touch has gone, pain has gone, temperature has gone. But fine touch is there, two-point discrimination is there, tactile localization is there, stereognosis is there. So this condition is known as dissociative anesthesia. Means there is dissociation in anesthesia. Some modalities are there and some modalities have gone. This is known as dissociative anesthesia. Pain is not there, but touch is there. That's all. Question is, explain why gallbladder pain is may be felt at neck. There was one, what will happen and why, what will happen to the left arm when there is myocardial infarction. Same thing, same principle, same theory would be applied here. Okay, it is due to referred pain. In MIE, myocardial infarction or heart attack, the pain is referred to the inner aspect of the left arm or to the jaw or to the shoulder tip, and sometimes it is referred to the right arm also. In the gallbladder pain, may be felt at neck because of the same referred pain, because I have already told you which structures are made from the same embryonic segment. They have referred pain phenomena. In this gallbladder and neck structure, both are evolved from the same embryonic segment. So there is some nerve supply crossing over. One is facilitation theory and one is convergence theory. In this, the nerves coming from the skin of the neck and the nerves coming from the gallbladder, both are going to the same higher order neuron. That is, the second order neuron is getting impulse from both the structure. Okay. So whenever pain is there, the brain will feel that it is coming from here because it cannot differentiate the pain coming from here or here. This is the convergence theory, and one is their facilitation theory. These are all about the referred pain or gallbladder pain may be felt at neck. Same reason is behind the diaphragmatic pain getting referred to the shoulder tip. And there are so many phenomena of referred pain in our body. That's all. Like this video, please share and subscribe it. And if you have any difficulty, let me know in the comment section.